Hi, boys and girls, Mr. Rivera. Today for art class, we're going to be talking about the artist Audrey Flack. She is a photorealist painter. So we're going to look at her work and learn a little bit more about photorealism. So she was born 1932. She is still alive and still making art. She is an American artist, mainly from New York City. And she is famous for her photorealism art. So what that means is that the art is painted in a way to make it look very realistic. So we can see here, it is very detailed, and a lot of her art looks a lot like photographs. So if you looked at it right away, you would think that you're actually looking at a picture, but these are paintings. Audrey Flack, she actually helped pioneer this style of art in the 1960s. For a while, people weren't doing things as realistically, but she started to do these very realistic paintings. They include lots of details and things like shadows and highlights that we're going to talk a little more about. She was actually one of the first people whose paintings were based off photographs. So she would set up items, take a picture of it, and would look at the photograph to paint rather than actually looking at the objects. A lot of her paintings are called still lives. Still life is pretty much when you set up a bunch of objects together and paint it. And the objects that she picks help tell a story. So when we're looking at these, a lot of these objects have a meaning that tell a story about what the painting's about. You can also see that she did a lot of art-related things too. We're actually going to look at that crayon one and do something inspired by it. So the way she makes her things look very realistic is she uses highlights and shadows to help make her art look real. Highlights are the brightest part of the object. It's often caused by the sun or a light source. So if a light is on something, you're going to notice that part of it has like a white spot. So we can see it right here along the plane. That tells us that the light is over on the left somewhere, and that's creating these highlights. Now the shadow it's the darkest part of the object. It's caused by the lack of light. So we can see here on the plane, the right or left side of the body, as well as the wing, the light isn't hitting it, so it appears darker. So when you do those things, when you add highlights and shadows, it's gonna help make your drawings look more realistic. You see a really good example here. If we don't add highlights or shadows, the objects, the eggs in this instance, look very flat. They just look like ovals, but by adding light and dark, the picture on the right, you can see that it is a three-dimensional object. There is a light source. So it's creating bright parts and dark parts. So what we're gonna do today is we're gonna create a drawing based on Audrey Flack's painting called Crayons. When we look at the picture or her painting, we can see that there are spots where it's white because that's the highlight. And there are spots that are dark. So we're gonna try to create a simpler version of this. So our goal is to have shadows and a highlight and as well as a color in between. So that helps create the effect that the crayons are 3D.
Okay, so I'm gonna show you guys how to do our drawing today. So right now we're looking at my finished work. You want to make sure that we draw at least three. You can always do more. And we're looking for shadows, so the black, as well as the dark, and highlights. So highlights is where I left it white. And then in the middle, I colored it lightly. All right, so first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to draw two lines. And then on one side, I'm going to draw a curved line. And then at the bottom, I'm going to draw almost like a V shape. So this is the front of the crayon. I'm going to draw another line here. So that's helping us know that this is a curved object. And I'm going to draw the little crayon logo. Okay. So now I want to pick my color. I'm going to do blue. And I want to make sure that at the bottom, I am going to color very dark. So I'm putting pressure on my crayon. So that tells you that this side is dark and this side's going to be light. Now in the middle, I'm going to color lightly. Okay, but I am leaving the very top is going to be white because that's going to be my highlight. I have my highlight here. See, I left it white. Now I'm going to get a black crayon and I'm going to do the darkest shadow. So just trace the line. If you want to, you can make it a little wider. Okay, and the last step would be draw your line. So you are going to draw two more crayons. As we saw in my example, you can make it a smaller piece, you can make it a regular piece, it's up to you. All right, so you just want to be sure to take a picture when you are finished and upload to Google Classroom by Friday.
Okay, so to review, your assignment will be to draw three or more crayons on your paper. Your crayon needs to have a shadow and highlights, and you want to make sure that you take a picture when you're finished and upload to Google Classroom by Friday. I also included a PowerPoint presentation that goes over the steps, so you can refer to this video or you can just look at the presentation when you are doing the assignment. All right, so I will talk to you guys next week. Hope you guys have fun doing this assignment.